So students, today we are going to see about the upper lobe, both the side lumb, apical segment. Now see, apical segment is like a triangular or a conical shape. Okay, so it has two parts. Okay, it has an anterior part and it has a posterior part. So for the anterior part, if we want to drain the secretions from the anterior apical, then the patient should be sitting with the relaxed sitting. Okay, so patient should be having a relaxed sitting, which means patient should sit with the support, back support should be there for the apico anterior segment. Okay, and in this position we can tell the patient to breathe deeply and cough. Okay, so that we can remove those secretions, so the secretions will be drained directly into the larger airways. Now, if the secretions are copious, there are some maneuvers for the posterior drainage. So, those maneuvers should be performed over the patient's particular where the segments are located. So, those maneuvers, first name is percussion, which you have come across a term as a clapping. In the massage, first year BPT mein, you have learned this technique of in the massage, known as a clapping. So in which we do a clapping over the part of the segment located, so that the secretions can be mobilized whichever are adhered to the airways. Okay, so if the secretions are very thick and they are very much adhered to the airways, then in that case we are supposed to mobilize or loosen up the secretions. How do we loosen up the secretions? We can percuss over the area where the segment is located, and by this we can loosen up the secretion. Now for the percussion, therapist should be not be wearing any type of ornament, so I will be removing my ornaments. Okay, after that we should inspect the area. Okay, I will be checking the patient breathing pattern, whether the patient is having any type of respiratory distress or not. Apparently patient doesn't have any type of respiratory distress. I am allowing clothing. Okay, there is no problem. If the thin clothing is there, it is perfectly all right, but it should not be having a thick clothing. Okay, or double layered clothing should not be there, otherwise the impact of the percussion will be ineffective. How to percuss? As you can see, it is a small area. So this is a small area, and that is why we should percuss with the one hand. Okay, so with the small area I will percuss with the one hand. How, where am I percussing? I am percussing over the clavicle, above the clavicle I am percussing. Okay, superior to the clavicle. Okay, so into the this super above the clavicle I am going to percuss. I will be percussing for the at least 1 minute, and then during this percussion maneuver I will be asking a patient, sir, kindly periodically you take a deep breath, knowing that you will not be able to hyperventilate, so avoid hyperventilation. Instruct a patient that beech mein you are supposed to take a deep breathing for few times, not more than 5 times at a stretch. Okay, this is how you will percuss over the anterior apical region. Now for the posterior side, we can shift the patient to the forward leaning position. In the forward leaning position, we should ask the patient to, sir, kindly lean on the couch. So as we know, the patient is leaning on the couch. Okay, here the area is above the spine of the scapula. Okay, so over this area I am going to percuss. Okay, so with one hand I can percuss, because this is a very small area, I cannot use two hands. Okay, and that is why I am percussing over the posterior side of the, over the posterior apical region, that is above the scapula. So I am percussing it. Okay, so this is how. Now, this is what is the apical segment. Now, the apical segment is equal in both side the lungs. Okay. So, whatever the position I am giving patient for the right side of the lung, and also it is for the left side. So, yes, I can also perform percussion, or I can also give position. I am also giving position for the left side apical segment, both anterior apical and posterior apical parts. Okay, this is how I am going to give position. As we have discussed, we will keep on percussing, we can keep on give the other maneuvers while the patient is in this position. Patient will be in this position for 5 to 10 minutes at least. Meanwhile, patient will be periodically taking a deep breath in between, and then at the end of the 5 minutes or 10 minutes maximum, I will ask patient to cough or huff. I will see whether the secretions are productive or not. If not, then I will progress to the another position for this segment, which are to be drained. Okay. So, for the anterior segment, upper lobe, right side and left side, the position is similar, and that is in a supine lying without any type of tilting of the bed. I am introducing a new term of bed tilt that we will learn in the next positions. Okay. Now, this is the on level surface plinth, okay, on which patient is lying supine. Okay. I have asked patient to lie in a supine position, which means, sir, kindly lie on your back. Okay. So, patient is in supine position. I will first identify the segment on the surface. It is located just above the nipple area. Okay. Anterior segment is just above the nipple area. So, if secretions are inside the this segment, then the secretion will be drained with these positions. Okay. So, this with these positions, the secretion will be drained into the larger airways. Now, if the secretions, as we have discussed earlier, if it is a very thick one or a adhered secretion, then in that case, we are supposed to perform a maneuvers. The one, first of all, first maneuver is the percussion. So, percussion you can use with the both the hands over here. I am percussing with the both hands. I am percussing above the nipple area, just below the clavicle. How am I supposed to percuss? I am going to percuss for at least 1 minute. Okay. I am seeing that the patient is taking deep breaths during this maneuver. Okay. So, percussion can be done during the inspiration and expiration, both the phases. Now, I am introducing another term, another maneuver, which name is a vibration. Okay. Vibration maneuver will be given during the exhalation or expiration phase. What does the vibration maneuver does? Vibration directs the secretions which are loosened up. It will direct the secretions from the peripheral to the larger airways, to the central airways, so that from there, once a patient coughs, then it will be removed out. Okay. So, this is how the vibration works. So, we are supposed to first apply percussion over the area, and then we are supposed to apply a vibration over the area. During which phase? During expiration phase, the vibration should be given. So, as you can see, I am putting my hands with a superimposed positions. This is a superimposed, okay? One hand over the another. With the superimposed position, now see, in this case, we are not supposed to have a clothing over the vibration, because vibratory maneuvers are to be done without any clothing. Okay, so without cloth, I am excluding the cloth. Okay, so without any clothing, I am putting a hand over the area, and with the contractions of the upper extremities, I am performing maneuver during exhalation. So in which we are supposed to vibrate the hands with the help of the upper extremity co-contraction. Okay, so this is how I am supposed to give during exhalation phase. We will check whether the patient is inhaling or not, and after during the exhalation period we are supposed to give vibration. I hope that it is clear to you. Now this is an anterior segment. Anterior segment I have performed here for the left side. It is same for the right side also. For the right side you are supposed to go to the other side and then you are supposed to perform. Okay, so for the right side for the upper lobe anterior segment, left and right side, both side of the lungs, the position is same and there is no any change. The next position is